Nithyanandam paramasukhadam kevalam jnanamurtim dvandvatitam gaganasadrisam tattvamasya adilakshyam ekam nityam vimalamachalam sarvade sakshibhutam bhavatitam trigunarahitam sadgurum tam namami. Nithyanandam, my name is Sri Ramanatha Maharaj and I am Bhautika Brahmachari of Nithyananda Swami. Paramahamsa Nithyananda Swami is the real living incarnation of Sadashiva, who has happened on the planet Earth to revive the whole Sanatan Hindu Dharma with all his glories. And so basically in the last video I was sharing how a sannyasi is relevant to the society, or why a society should encourage the sannyas lifestyle. So I was saying, I would like to repeat few things. Like a society, if you see, basically is driven by two major emotions, I can say, or which is the undercurrent in all the activity that we do, everything that we do. The one is fear and another is greed. Either you are driven by the fear or you are driven by the greed. These are the two things which control the life of almost every being, with any exception. It could be exception if you are living in the presence of an enlightened master, or a master like His Holiness Paramahamsa Nithyananda Swami, or you yourself are enlightened master, enlightened. So the society reveres, respects everything that actually comes in this frame, whichever can fulfill their greed, desire, and it respects to those things also which cause fear in them. A lot of things are respected in the society just because they are afraid of it. Sometimes many people associate, many people feel that the people have devotion towards the God just because they have fear of the God. It may be true to the certain percentage, let's say 1% or 2%. Okay, I do not agree with the fact that most of the people have devotion just because they are afraid of the God. So, let us take the example. If somebody in the society, we find so many people choosing the lifestyle of an engineer. Some people become a businessman. There are different fields where people choose to become businessmen. People become doctors. People become artists, actors, and whatnot. And most of them, almost everybody, gets the respect based on what and how much they are contributing to the society. If you see, in a society, if you go to any villages, any city, the doctors are one of the most respected professionals who get lot of respect from the society. Because almost every single body, every single being has got benefited from the doctor, including me, including you, and everybody almost at least once or twice in our life we visit the doctor. So we experience how a doctor is relevant to us, how he is how he needs to be protected, or my son or my kid or our family member or somebody from our society should be taking this job. So many people take up this job of becoming a doctor. Some people may say okay, because they get paid they become the doctor, because they get paid. So many things, getting the money is one of the important components, but any of the field which is progressing, which is developing continuously, research and developments are happening, it doesn't happen just because they are getting paid, because they are so passionate about it. And so many people are so dedicated, they feel responsible for the society. They feel their responsibility that they need to devote their time, energy, their very life to develop certain things, certain technology, certain sciences, so that it can help the humanity live a better life. So the people understand, a lot of people understand this, and they take part, they encourage, they invest their money in all this. The same way I can say, the sannyas, one of the very important components of Sanatan Hindu Dharma, it may be like last few hundred years only, only last few hundred years that the sannyas lifestyle is being less feared by the society. But it becomes basically one of the main reason becoming they also, or the society ignoring them, or they becoming less relevant to the society, is because they either not coming and telling people what and what way they are helping the society, contributing to the society, or some of them have not taken responsibility for the society. So I'd like to say there are just because we have not been telling, or the many of the sannyas organization I know personally, they have been contributing left and right to the society, but they did not use, or they did not promote themselves. They did not use this part. They should be promoting what they are doing to the society. There are tons of organizations. If I just said, at least all the organizations are involved in the serving food to the free food to lot of the people who are in the need of food. In the education sector, in the health sector, there are three minimum that almost all the organizations are involved, which is very visible, but somehow, like other organizations, other the private companies, they are not involved in showing how much they are contributing to the society. Other than that, the actual, if I say where their importance is much more than doing any of the work, is doing R&D in the consciousness. In the consciousness. And that is what, like, they give the breakthrough in your consciousness. A continuous research so that you go on progressing, go on discovering new you. And that is what is the job of a sannyasi. So if you have ever been enriched by a sannyasi, if you have got the breakthrough in the your consciousness, be very sure it is the contribution of a sannyasi. I'll continue talking on this topic further in another coming videos. Till now, I'll thank you all of you being with me. Thank you, Nithyanandam.